एवरीबॉडी डेवलप ए न्यू बीइंग क्लास
कम ऑन
न्यू बीइंग क्लास राइट क्लिक ऑन डेमो फोर गो टू द न्यू सेलेक्ट क्लास Choose a class name as address. Finish. House number. H in the lower case. N in the upper case. Street name. S in the lower case. N in the upper case. House number, street name. A new bean class with two fields. A new bean class with two fields. Develop setters and getters. Generate setters and getters. Select all. Click on generate. Try saving. Control S. I showed you already how to develop a setters and getters. Control Z. I'll show you one more time. Right click at line number 6. Go to the source. Generate setters and getters. Select all. Click on generate. Control S. Now, everybody, again right click demo 4, right click demo 4, go to the new, select a class. I am choosing class name as a student. Click on finish. Private string first name of the student, F in the lower case, private string last name of the student, L in the lower case, private integer. Age of the student. Private. Let me go for string array. Maybe project names. P in the lower case. N in the upper case. Private. Collection object. Come on. Private array list. email IDs. One simple point here, ArrayList should be imported. There is a red mark here. Press Control Spacebar. Guys, bring the cursor next to the T. Bring the cursor next to the T. Control Spacebar. Press Enter. Remove the angle bracket. Everybody try importing ArrayList. Private address. I have used string type, wrapper type, array type, collection API type, has a relation. Student has an address. Student has an address. Student class, first name, last name, age. Student class, string array. Student class, ArrayList, collection content. Student class, address. Student has an address. It is another bean. Student itself has a bean. Inside that, one more bean. Like a member, like a part, has a relation. Generally, while developing any project, you will be having a complex bean, something like this. Student having one first name, one last name, one age. He may be having multiple project names. He may be having multiple email IDs. He is having address. All the things we have to encapsulate. Definitely it will become a little complex. Now I showed here single value fields, multiple value fields like a string, array and ArrayList from the collection. Later, user defined a bean address. It is also containing multiple values like a house number and street name. Now, come to the line number 12. Develop setters and getters. Right click on line number 12. Right click on line number 12. Go to the source. Generate getters and setters. Select all, generate, generally in any project you will be finding this type of bean class. The bean class containing single value fields like a first name, last name, age, multiple value fields like a project names which is a string array. Email IDs, which is a collection object. Address, which is another bean type. Developers, getters. Now let us develop a REST API which has to return student object. REST API which should return student object. Come back to the test controller. Everybody. Public student test 7 let me define first address object. Address dot set house number I'm going for 120 slash yum. Set street name Big Yum. Address object is ready. Let us define array list. Array list should be imported. Control space bar. Import array list. Control space bar. Press enter. Remove the angle brackets. Define a list. New array list. List dot add. Inside a student, array list is for email IDs. Try storing email ID a@a.com. This is one email ID. a@b.com. This is another email ID. c.com. Now define a string array. Project names. So something like Citibank Automation, one project. HDFC Bank Automation. Access Bank Automation. You can consider these are the project names. Three containing multi-value fields in the student. Now we are ready to define a student object. We defined address. We defined address and stored house number, street name. We defined array list. We stored multiple email IDs. We defined a string array and we stored multiple project names. With this data, try define student object. Student dot single value field first name. Let's go for ABC as a first name. Last name. Set age single value field. Student dot set address student dot set email IDs student dot set project names. Completely defined student object. Return the same. It's a little bigger API. Try developing everybody exactly as it is. In the real time project, it's definitely much more bigger than this. You should have a more coding practice. Save all the files through Ctrl-Shift-S. Ctrl-Shift-S to save all the files. And we need to provide a URL through request to mapping. Please observe, request to mapping is pending. Let's go for T7. Restart the application. Stop the application. Start it. Now open a browser, give a call to T7. Observe this output also, everybody. I'm copying into the edit list. You can see this is one field. We returned a student object. The student object containing first name, last name, age, project names, email IDs and address. Check it out. This type of development is called as a JSON object. Please observe. This format is JSON object. JavaScript object notation. JavaScript object notation. JSON object. JSON object. So we have seen every type of return from the REST web service, including complex objects, collection objects, arrays, primitives, string, has a relation, everything we have seen, what we can able to return. In the next topic, we will see input to the REST web service. Till now we have seen output from the REST web service, returning a value to the callers of the REST web service. Now let us see input, giving a input to the REST web service.